I am going to talk about how to clean a transcription file. And so these files are often, you see them in Zoom or other places, where the reason they're set up the way they are is because they are able to sync the words to the video. However, there's times where we want to have that interview, for instance, and be able to clean it so that we can use it. So the files will end in VTT. And so first thing you'll do is you're gonna try to open it, and Notepad is probably a way to do that. So you're gonna open it in Notepad, and it's gonna look like this. So you've got all of these numbers, timestamps that you're trying to clean, as well as the numbers of I guess they just have markings for each one. So what you're gonna do is then you're gonna open up Excel and go ahead and do that. All right, so I've got an Excel book now. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get on this VTT, and I'm gonna copy all. So Control A and then Control C. So I'm gonna copy this and I'm gonna put it on the Excel file. And then right A1, I'm gonna copy and paste. So Control V, paste. Control V, paste on B2. And then Control V, paste on C3. So now I've got three sets of this exact same VTT transcript. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna highlight all three of these, just like that. And then I'm going to go to, let's see, wait 1 second. Okay, it's gonna go to the find icon and you go down to special. So under special, you'll see something that says blank. And I click on that and I press okay. What that does is it detects all the blanks in these three columns. Then I right click and I click delete. And the delete I want is the entire column. So I'm going to delete the entire column, press OK, and boom. I've got this where the transcript is right there. These are the numbers. And then these are, I guess, the designated numbers for each line. What I do is I just go ahead and delete these two. So all I've got is a transcript. Now here, what I like to do is then I find and replace the names. So for instance, this is my name. And then I'll replace it with something a little shorter. So replace all. And then the other person here, his name is iPhone. And then I replace his name and replace all. Okay, so then I've got this. And then what I'll do is I will copy this A line. So I'm gonna scroll down and just go ahead and copy the entire conversation. Actually, you know what? I think I might just go ahead and be able to do that. Just click on the A and copy. And then this is what I like to do. I go to Word. So I'm going to open Microsoft Word. I click OK. So once I do that, if I just let it be the way I have the setting, it's going to have it in like a table form. So what I want is I find the control button here, right under where I did that. And then I just click on the last one, which is just a clipboard with an A, and that's keep text only. So I click that. And that allows us so that the only thing I have is a text. So that it's not in like the table form. All right, so I've got me and I've got Sebastian here. And here's the thing is the way Zoom works is every time I say, which I say pretty often, it goes to the next line. So I end up where I've got grace, 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 rather than having it all together. And so the way I kind of fix that is I will highlight where it ends, so where Sebastian starts, actually right before the first grace, so, or right after, sorry, right after the first grace. So I'm going to highlight all of this. And then what I do is I go to edit, find, replace. And so what I'm finding is a paragraph mark. So that caret P and then the word race, like that. And then, so there's two ways you can do this. If you're sure that it is ums and you want to have that in your transcript, then you can replace it with right? And then, so then what happens is in this selection that I've selected, if I say replace all, it does that section and boom, I've got that clean. Do you want to search the rest of the document? You want to say no, because if you do it this way, then it's going to replace all the graces and you want the first one of each section. So I say no, but then I can go down and say, okay, for this one right here. And then I just click the one I want to get rid of. So make sure I highlight that one and replace all and it does it. And then I press no. Now, right here, I realized I should have put a space. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So put a space before the and then I'll do this next section like that. So all the way until I hit right before Sebastian and right after the first grace and I replace all and then search the rest and no, and then I have that. Now, if you don't want to replace it with of course, just replace it with a space bar, right? And then so I'll do that. And then in this next section, it will be replace all. And no. And so what happens then you clean it so that all the graces are together and you eliminate the extra ones. And then so once I finish that, then I'm gonna do it with the next person. So let's just assume I've got that finished. Then I'm gonna do it with Sebastian. And same thing. I write this so caret P, which means paragraph. And then whatever I'm replacing, which is Sebastian and the semicolon, and then I replace it with a space. So I go to here where there's three of them. I highlight the last two, don't highlight the first one, replace all and boom. And do you want to search? No. And then I'll move on to the next one and do that. See, so now when this is all done, I've got something that is a lot cleaner that I can work with. As I do this. Okay, so hopefully this video helped, and shoot me some questions or suggestions if you have them. All right, have a good day.